Hey guys, Jason here, Chuck Guys. Let's look at gold again. We're gonna start in the daily time frame, and I'm looking at this and I'm seeing that 1346 resistance, and I'm looking at a tightening range over the last two candlesticks and what we're seeing so far today. So what that says to me is we need to be watching for equilibriums. Anytime we get inside bars, that's some sort of tightening range, and you need to look at a smaller time frame to get a read on what is happening. So when I'm looking at inside bars, I look at my two levels, the highest and lowest ranges of my inside bars. That sets up the potential EQ range that we want to be looking for. Then we jump to our 4 hour time frame. And there we go. Here's our inside bar. And we can also use this 1344 as our first area of resistance. So we've come down here, we've set this low, we've set a lower high. Now we need to see if we're going to set a higher low. If we set a higher low, that range continues to tighten. We have ourselves a beautiful equilibrium pattern. And if the bulls are going to make another attempt at 1346 and break that monthly level, this is exactly what they want to see. To spend as much time up here gathering strength, allowing RSIs to cool off before they make an attempt at it. So, should they get a nice bullish EQ break, knockout 1346, our next resistance is going to be where? Up here, 1366. That's the high of the next daily resistance. So quite a ways to go and a lot of territory the bulls can cover without a lot of resistance. So they can coil up and get that strength and hit that level. They got a lot of potential here. But until that happens, the monthly weekly time frame is still giving us a bias toward the downside. So we need to prepare for that as well. And if we learned anything in yesterday's video, it's you need to be prepared for both eventualities. So, if we continue to tighten this pattern, what we're going to look for is to see what our next potential higher low is going to be. And then that is going to be the new level for our EQ. So, for example, if we decide that this is going to be our level and we watch this range tighten up, let's zoom in a little bit to see what it might look like. If we decide that's our higher low, we go up here, we set a new lower high, another higher low, and you just continue to tighten, and eventually you get this triangle shape. Now, it's not a pennant, it's an equilibrium. They have a little bit of a different set of rules to them. And when we're playing an EQ, what we're concerned about most of all is the most recent lower high. When that breaks, then you get a move and a lot of emphasis and a lot of direction, a lot of power, I guess, in that direction. And that's what we're watching for. So we've already talked about the upside. If we break bearish, we lose, in this case, our example, 1332.228. This is not a level yet because it's not set. But if we lost that level, we would look to knock out the next level, 1327. Then we have 4 hour support down here at our low of 320, and then nothing on the 4 hour for quite a ways. So in both cases, the bulls have moved rapidly to the upside, not establishing a lot of support, and there's a lot of area to expand to the bull side as well. So in both cases, we have a potential for quite substantial quick moves to the upside and to the downside. Everything for me right now is going to be hinging on what this equilibrium or potential equilibrium happens to do. So if we get a nice tight EQ, that's really going to set us up well for the next 24 hours. Keep an eye on that, watch those levels evolve, and make a plan for how you're going to react to it, what you're going to trade. And just be prepared, guys. It's all about these beautiful setups, and you just stock the trade, wait for the trade to come to you, and then be ready to capitalize on it the moment it breaks because you need to get in there before everyone else does. That's it for today. I'm gonna be watching this beautiful EQ. Gonna go have some dinner, and I know I'm gonna be checking the charts again because that's all I do. I love this stuff. All right, guys, talk to you tomorrow.